I could use three words to describe the expertise of my research. So one is definitely data mining, and the other is software engineering, because it's the place where our problems are defined. And also I'm working on applied machine learning. So I would say I have expertise on these three research aspects. For the reasons for coming to Queens, actually, I would say there are three reasons. The first one is actually I'm not new to Kingston or new to Queens, because back in 2015, I was very lucky to be invited as a visiting researcher here in the School of Computing. I have a chance to get used to the city, the Kingston, and also Queens. I find it's a very nice, nice place to stay, and the people here are very nice. They like to help with each other, so it's a very great experience. And the second reason is definitely we know that there are many outstanding researchers here in the School of Computing at Queen's University, and they are very active, especially in my research area. So I would think that it will be very great for me to have a chance to collaborate with these outstanding researchers. And the third reason is that after talking with my friend, I know that and get some information from the media, so I know that Queen's University usually have a very high reputation, and that also means the quality of students here is very high, and that also means maybe I have a good chance to find a good candidate for a PhD or master by research. So that's the three main reasons why I came to Queen's. So as you know, I'm working in a kind of closed area of data mining and software engineering. So my research interests mainly to see how the data-driven approaches can really change the way people develop software. So for example, in the past, we have done many research that trying to utilize very large-scale software data set, such as the projects on GitHub or the questions and answers on Stack Overflow, and trying to mine the knowledge and to get some insight that can help the developers to improve their the process of software development. So that's my research interest. So I would say that I could see a kind of AI empowered, so AI means artificial intelligence, empowered software development in the next probably 10 years. So that means I want to see how the data-driven approach that we have proposed can really change the way how people develop software. And the second aspect is we can also see how the evolution of software engineering can contribute back to the future of artificial intelligence. Because we know that in order to increase the impact of AI in different areas, we need to create different tools, or you can say different softwares. So in that sense, that means the software engineering can come and help people building the tools so that more and more people can evolve in the trends of the future of AI. And regarding or related to that, we can also see some other things will happen in the next 10 years. For example, how the people or human factors will be more and more important in these two areas, because in the end, we are not trying to use machine to replace humans, but let human to make use of the machine and to improve their working efficiencies. So we will see how the human factors will evolve in this kind of research, and also there are other aspects such as the privacy and the security issues. When we are doing the research, we also need to consider that. So I will see that these are the four important topics that will happen in the next 10 years in my research field. So my PhD thesis is mainly about mining software repository to do automated bug management. So you can see from the title that it's mainly focusing on bug report. However, nowadays my research is more towards including more kind of data set. For example, the API recommendation task, we are analyzing API, and also question and answers on Stack Overflow. And then we are even focusing on some conversations that developers may have during the process of software development. So that means the kinds of data set we are focusing on now expand from the bug reports to many other kinds of data set. And the second thing is that in the past, I have built many machine learning models that can get a very high accuracy for many of the problems. However, we find that these solutions might not be all actionable for developers. So in the future, or currently, I'm focusing on to building some recommendation system which are more expandable and robust to developers so they can really use them in their real life. So that's the difference between my PhD thesis and what I'm doing right now. So for graduate students, I think the most important thing is about this person should be self-motivated. So because I think passion is like the motivation for doing research. And the second thing that I hope she or she will have a high level of commitment. So that means they can take responsibility for their projects and knowing how to manage their time, how to communicate or collaborate with other members in the same team. The third aspect I would see is ability to think. So that means the person should have some understanding towards how research generally work. There is a formal process or workflow to follow. He needs to know how to analyze the data, how to collect the data, and how to perform some general experiment. So that's also very important for graduate students. Last but not the least, if the students can have some experience, especially the research experience in the areas where are similar to mine, then I think it would be very good. So I would definitely think this person is very suitable for my research lab. I think there are multiple reasons why people should choose choose computer science or join this field, because first, we all know that there's a lot of needs either from industry side or the research area. They are asking for people or students who come from the computer science background. So that means once you have joined this program, you might have more opportunities after you graduate from the program. So that's very good. And this aspect is related to the needs. And the second thing is that we know that computer science is really about creating something new. And in that sense means after you have completed the program, you will have a chance to apply whatever you have learned in the university and try to use them in solving the real world problem. So in that sense, you can see how what the knowledge that you have learned, how they can have a huge impact in the society. So that's more focusing on the impact of after you having the computer science degree. The other things aspect is like from the skill training aspect. I was thinking if you have joined the computer science program, you will be able to train very important skills such as problem solving skills. And these kind of skills, no matter what kind of job or career path you will choose after you graduate, they will always be very helpful for you. So you can choose either go for economics or business positions. Problem solving skills is also very important, and you can get trained in a computer science program. And the other important skills you can train by joining the computer science program is that you will know how you can collaborate with different peoples, because we all know that nowadays software can be very large scale, and usually in order to develop a software, there's a lot of people need to work together. So by starting in the computer science area, you are able to learn how you can collaborate with different people, so that these kind of general skills will go along with your whole life, and they will contribute to your future careers. I think I'm enjoying staying in this field, computer science, is because it's a very exciting field. It's very young and currently it's very fast growing. So that means people keep coming up with new ideas, and you will see many applications of your ideas. And most importantly, it will have a huge impact on how people live their lives. So you can see many softwares have changed the life that we have, like the Ubers and Airbnbs. So that's really shows that how the computer science field can change the world. Outside computer science, I'm more excited about social science studies, because although I'm working on data-driven approaches, but currently at this stage, I don't think that machines or AI can can purely replace the work that people have done. So that means most of the time we are trying to create new tools that can be used by human and trying to improve their working efficiency. So in that way, it means that we need to have some conversations or communications with different human to understand what is the requirement from their side and if we have, after we have building the tools, and how we can use the tool to improve their life. So I'm thinking that besides computer science, if you have some knowledge or background about social science, you will be very helpful when you're communicating with different peoples and to understand their needs.